The following is a production of New Mexico State University.
We're at the base of Albuquerque Sandia Mountain in the garden of Master Gardener Margot Murdoch. This garden was originally designed by prominent xeriscape designer Judith Phillips. Margot, is it retaining that design?
Yes and no. Originally, Judith came up with a beautiful design, but as plants have died and as we've had problems in the yard, or as I wanted to add my personality to it, we've changed the plants. Mm-hmm. So it's changed over time.
Gardens have to change though, don't they?
Yes, they do.
And you start with a good plan and then you just kind of go and make it yours.
Yes.
And I see some beautiful things here. Most striking though is the Leotris right now.
And it's planted in a ribbon. That's one of Judith's concepts, is that you plant wildflowers in a ribbon, and then what's happened is some of them have receded. So we have some over there and some over here, and that's God's version of the changing the plant.
Moving themselves around. And they're not very difficult to grow here, are they?
No, they're not. And they're one of the fall blooming plants, which makes them really nice, too.
Really good. And then you've got, I see some tall grasses here. Is this little blue stem?
Yes, this is little blue stem.
And
there's also sand blue stem as well.
Okay, that's a new one for me. It looks good. And then the base planting here is buffalo grass and blue gramma grass?
Yes.
You had an interesting result when it rained, didn't you?
Yes, when the meadow was first put in, we got some rain. And the rain washed the blue gramma seed to the edges, mm-hmm. and the buffalo stayed in the middle. We have a lot of, right at the edge of this dry stream that we're standing in, we have mm-hmm. a lot of the blue gramma.
And I see real New Mexico here because we've got the purple aster that's so common throughout New Mexico in the fall. And so this is part of your meadow.
Yes, it is. It's come in. It's a volunteer.
Volunteered. And it will volunteer itself a lot more.
I think that's nice.
Anyone who has this, in time you start weeding it out a little bit, a lot.
Margot also includes some of the permaculture concepts of Bill Mollison.
Well, this is a spiral.
It is. The idea behind Mollison's spiral herb garden is that when you grow something in this spiral form and you actually go up, you're getting more garden space to plant.
So the plants are able to use that vertical space.
They are. And you also have more dirt, so you have more root space.
And if you need a raised bed, this kind of helps develop a raised bed kind of planting as well.
And it's just neat to see the plants hang over. It was also very difficult to irrigate this properly. So mm-hmm. we ended up with two inline drip pieces that run all the way down the spiral to the base.
Okay. And Bill Mollison is the father of permaculture, so he's a good person to develop this.
The preceding was a production of New Mexico State University. The views and opinions in this program are those of the author and do not necessarily represent the views and opinions of the NMSU Board of Regents.